We're gonna watch the fancy schmancy, newly rendered intro. Funny story, Connor. I was craving ice cream last night, so I walked to BK and got an Oreo. Yes, Oreo sundae milkshake. Yes. I wonder if this will get flagged for copyright. Probably. Whatever. It's worth it. Man, now I want to go get burgers and shake. I love Star Wars related media. Me too, Cena. This is giving me flashbacks. Yeah, heck yeah. What's cool is NightDive re-rendered all of the assets in this, and it, not AI upscaling, like they like redid it themselves. And all of the cutscenes have been redone. All of the like 3D models have been redone. It's very impressive. Granted, this is my first time playing the game itself. I just played the Avenger mission last night because I just had to. I couldn't resist the siren call of the Avenger mission, which I will play on stream. I'll probably save that for the end of stream, but. Ooh, look at that. Ooh. I think it just plays the credits then, yeah. Select mission. Secret base. Yes. I'm gonna keep it on easy just so that I can blaze through most of this. Oh, we got Mon Mothma there. We're stealing the Death Star plans on the secret base on planet Denuta. Once you have the plans, get out immediately. Operation Skyhook will deliver the plans to Princess Leia on the consular ship Tanov 4. There we go. Mon Mothmom. Desnuda. Love Andor, but Kyle Katarn would absolutely whoop Cassian Andor's butt. Cassian Andor is absolutely Kyle Katarn. He is absolutely that guy, especially because they gave Cassian Andor Kyle Katarn's blaster. There we these textures look so dope. I played this on an Apple II back in back in the day, and it was scuffed as fuck. Did this come out on an Apple II? I don't think it did. I think that was past its time. It did come out on Mac at some point, like a Mac OS. OS 8, 9, whatever. I don't know. Definitely not 9, but. It certainly didn't, but I grew up with a Mac in a Mac house. Okay. I had this on. This was one of the first PC games This is one of the first PC, actually one of the first video games that I played. When my dad got a home computer for the house, we had Mortal Kombat, Star Wars Dark Forces, and Mad Dog McCree. I forget how you get back there. Oh, is there like a... I forget how you get back here. Ugh. Spire was a household.
Too easy. Now I get to my ship.
Just make sure there's no one else hiding there. Oh, I have shields too. One. I can always use more ammo. Battery? No, my battery's full. I'm good. Oh, oh, hello. Okay, gotta go ride the bus. I'll be lurking with the gherkin. Alright. Enjoy your bus ride. And enjoy some Dark Forces. Pretty render. Next mission.
Kyle delivers the plans to the Rebel Alliance. Soon afterwards, the Death Star is destroyed. But even as the Alliance celebrates this victory,
it is a cool ship, Cena.
Set in motion that will become an even greater concern for the Rebellion.
I feel like the MIDI's going a little crazy. Also, the music's a little loud.
Thank you, Lord Vader. What I unveil today will mark a new era for the Empire. We will be able to decimate the rebels just as we did the Jedi Knights. At last, the Emperor's war will be filled only with the glory and beauty of decisive victory.
A noble cause, General. I hope the demonstration lives up to your claims. Proceed.
With pleasure. Dark Trooper.
General, the Emperor will be most pleased. Continue with your project.
Certainly, Lord Vader.
Thank you, Commander, for responding at such short notice. The Empire has been keeping us on the run since the destruction of the Death Star. 5 days ago, the Empire attacked one of our secret bases in the city of Talay.
This is Tech Base to anybody out there. Please, we're under Imperial attack. They broke through our shield.
Tech base was destroyed within minutes. Many innocent people in the surrounding city, as well as the rebel staff, were killed. Intelligence thinks that this may be an act of retaliation for the destruction of the Death Star.
Interesting. This looks like it could be a normal Imperial attack, except for those sounds.
Very perceptive, Commander. I know you understand that all we discuss here is classified. This Imperial officer, Crix Medine, wishes to defect to the Alliance. He has supplied us with information on the development of a new Imperial weapon. Those sounds you heard, we believe, come from that weapon. A new type of stormtrooper, the Dark Trooper.
A new stormtrooper that can take out a rebel base that quickly? I should have kept working for the Empire.
The Rebel Command is not taking this lightly. They have authorized me to hire you to find out if there is a threat, and if there is, to shut it down. That is, if you are still on our side.
This could be interesting. Alright, I'm in. But I think I'll need some help on this one. I want Jan Ors as my mission officer.
Certainly. Then I will let Jan brief you further on your mission objectives. Thank you, Commander. And may the Force be with you.
I'm absolutely turning the music down. I could barely hear a dang thing they were saying. Turning my volume down, too. Dang, I'm peaking here. Alright. We gotta restart. I'm kind of blazing through the briefings here just because, man, I've played this game so many times. I play it about once a year. And I played it, I did stream the complete game last year on Dark Forces anniversary. And for this stream, I kind of just want to showcase the game a bit, but I'll try and do it a little bit of service here. But find and restart hydroelectric power generator. Find some clue to the Dark Trooper and return to the landing area. Damn, those loading times are fucking quick. sound. Here we go. Where's the music? Oh, fuck. That's why. Fucking bring this up. Oh, yo, we can go stereo. Oh, we can go surround sound on this. What? General Medi, what if we do? Oh, OPL3 is going to be like the original. Low pass filtering? What? Insane. Bring this down to like 90. To bring the music down probably a little bit more. Sound, music, let's bring it down to about 80. Bring it, make it a cool 80. God damn it, please make it 80. Swear to God. there's something else I also wanted to check. Ooh, there's accessibility options. What do we have? Ooh. Subtitles, absolutely. Mission. Let's do automatic for the mission ending. That's pretty cool, though. This is a crime to not being able to make it 80%, right? Oh, crouch type. There you go. That's another thing that was bugging me. It's on toggle. I'd rather have it as hold. Control binds. Here we go. Oh, heck. What's control? Control is probably fire. Or it's not mapped to anything. In which case, I'm mapping crouch to control. Boop. All right. That was the other thing that I wanted to do. I think that's it. Oh, is there, real quick, because I know some remasters do this, where they have a button where you can toggle through like the original graphics and the new graphics. I'm curious if render mode? Maybe that's what I'm thinking. Can I not use a function key for that, please? That would be Let's try it. Let's see how that goes. Oh, there we go. Okay. Ah, crusty mode. All right, cool. So automatic ending. So what that means is at the end of every mission, when you come back to your start point, so at the end of this mission, when I have to come back here, it will tell you to open the menu and click next mission. Because the last mission did that too. And so this will just end it. Presumably, it will just end it. But look at that. Look at that crust mode. Oh, so good. I love it. Ah! Yes, stream element. Yeah, where's Connie at? Connie needs to get in here. Concrew needs to get back together. The band needs to get back together. Ooh, weapon supercharged. This is fun. Fuck yeah. These are blue now, that's interesting. Originally red in the game. Run over here real quick. This is the coolest. Yeah, get him. Oh, man. Bye-bye, supercharge. Like I can just aim in any general direction and it'll fire. Very accurate to Star Wars, you know.
You're in violence.
Should give you a weapon supercharge out here instead of over there, just because you'll see why. They give you a shield supercharge, which is beneficial.
You're not all the way.
knows? This, and here we go. Ah, you're over here now. There we go. Wait.
Zap blasters on.
There you are. Oh, it's med kits. All right. I barely even... Well, I say I barely needed the shield supercharge, but I probably got hit a fair amount of times. I just didn't realize it. Yeah, yeah, the background music's awesome. That was, oh me, oh my, I do not remember this many enemies showing up at the end. Yeah, this music was done by LucasArts' very own, his last name is, it's Clint Bajakian, I think, if I remember that correctly. He really captured John Williams without, you know, really having to copy a lot of the Star Wars motifs, which is very impressive. Ah! The other Clint I know is Eastwood, so you're right. There we go. Okay, I was like, wait a minute. Okay, level 3. This is the one that a lot of people do not like. And I get why, but... looking for Moff Rabus. Where does it say? It's basically a giant sewer level where we're going to find Moff Rabus himself. But yeah, Clint Bajakian really did an amazing job with this soundtrack. Oh, grab these. Oh, there we go. So, here we go. Smells like progress. Enter the sewer. Great achievement there, NightDive. I also gotta watch out for Dinogas. Don't know if I need to be in this one. Actually, yeah. Yuck indeed. Oh, it's a remote. Where is it? Those guys suck. Yay. It's gonna be a lot of this. But then there's the worst part about this. I'm gonna have to go to the controls to remember what headlamp is. Headlamp is R. Okay. Interesting control for that, but okay. This is why I hated this level as a kid. And now we just go and we go. We're swimming. We're swimming. No. Wait. Oh shit. Stupid. Oh boy. Jesus. Let's grab some batteries because we're going to need them. I mean, we don't really need them now. But... there we go. There's one more in here. Show yourself. There isn't. Love the sound effect of the monster. It's a really good one. Let's not go down there just yet. Let's actually go into this place, what with the door that opened and such. Oh, fuck. Remotes. Hooray. Alright, well. Time to swim through more poop. It's just a straight shot. The worst part, because there is a wrong turn you can take. Oh, there is a wrong turn you can take and end up in a very bad spot. I don't think we even need. I don't even know what's in the fourth one. I say I don't know, but. one in here too. There we go. I think this just leads into badness, if I remember correctly. Yep, it leads to badness. All right. There's our other battery. There it be. And we go... Oop, oop, oop.
Sup, bitches. It's Chadwood in here.
Sup, bitches. Connie! Con Crew! How are you doing, Connie? How was your Monday? I heard that damaged a Dinoga. Here comes the worst part. Just fine, that's good. Just fine is a good way to... Just fine is a good way to have a Monday, I'll tell you that much. Whoop! That guy lives down here. Definitely looks like the kind of guy that would live down there. All right. So now we go to the Imperial Weapons Research Facility. So we're going to Fest. Infiltrate the base and find some samples of the metal that they're testing. Return to the landing area. Make this easier on myself on the way out. Oh! Actually, you know what? Screw it. Let's do it. He started it. He instigated this nonsense. If I can get... Whoop! Damn. And one more. There we go. Ah, screw it. I'll bring the fight to them.
You there.
Ah. Oh, I did take one of them out. All right. Take that extra extra life, too. All those little, like, all those little caves and all that. I know the pathway to get to some of them. So far, the remaster is really good. I've had to adjust some settings, like the music volume, because it was real loud. Turned on subtitles. But, I mean, so far it's really good. Whoop! Whoop! That's heavy. I'm just going spelunking. I'm glad you're enjoying it, Sina. That's good. That's always good. Oh, Egon. Ooh. Yo. Let's go back. Think about having some sausage for dinner. Oh, that sounds good. Can't go wrong with sausage. I'm probably gonna do mac and cheese for dinner. If I can make the jump. Whoop, make the jump! There we go. Pizza. Ah! Jeez, I was admiring the graffiti. It's a lot more prep. They really brought it out in this. It's a lot more legible. Where, like, what was it? It was this key. Where it's like, yeah, in the original version, you can barely notice it. Now you can really see it. Power cells actually look like a group of power cells.
There he is.
Not pick up the card. The code key, rather. Something. Oh, poor Ewoks. Salisbury steak with mashed potatoes. That sounds super yummy. First one, it just kind of looks like a box. Whoop, that is not what I wanted. That looks like a pack of batteries. There we go, got my code key. Open that door. Won't need it until later, but good to have it open. There it is. It's like, hey, I'm supposed to get this thing in this mission. Wrong door. Inventory. 3CD is what it looks like to me. Damn. Not hitting the broadside of a barn. Thank you. Oh, hell. I've always done it this way, so I'm probably doing it backwards. That level design. I actually really like the level design in this game. When I was a kid, I would honestly like draw out maps for my own levels for this game. Did I ever get a level editor and do that? No. I did do that with Jedi Knight, though. Actually, the level designers were architecture undergrads at Berkeley University, which I think is really cool. They were offered to, let me just remember where I'm going. I think it was this way. They're given the offer to work on this game or finish their degree, and they were like, you know what? We're gonna work on this game. It's really cool. Right? I think it was too.
Stop where you are.
Oh, that one just passed right through. Let's get out of here. Get the hell out of Dodge. My favorite thing to look at in game guide magazines were level maps. Even if I wasn't playing the game, something about seeing the maps really interested me. Right? Me too! I'd look at, like, the maps for, like, Dino Crisis, and it's like, I can't play... I'd be a kid, I can't play that game. My parents won't let me play that game, but I will absolutely enjoy looking at those maps. This metal you found is called Frick. It's a rare material that they... must be using for armoring the dark troopers. Sources come from Gromas. Locate the reactor and set the sequencer charge. Get back to the ship. First one. Miscusi. Got him. Map design must be difficult, but it's good if done right. Exactly. Yeah, there's probably a lot of, like, nuance that goes into it. Oh, you're here too. Gotta be a lot of, like, nuance and stuff that goes into it. Especially when you know, like, all the tricks of the engine that you're using, or the game engine. I won't pick up the supercharger just yet. God, it's so red.
Oh,
Ha! Can't itch my dang nose. Telling me a fruit punch this beverage? Exactly. They modified easy mode by like adding in more enemies. I definitely don't remember there being this many enemies. Granted, I'm not complaining, but. The Empire would be like, hey, maybe we'll build pathways around the Crushers. But what are they here? Oh, Jesus. Oh, there's a blue key. Whoa, there we go. Oh, God, that was horrifying. Forgot what mission this was for a second. Not me.
You're not authorized.
Romeo. There we go. Dang. Oh. 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 Scariest leap of faith ever. Whoop. Nope, that didn't work the way I wanted it to. What the? Am I going the right way? I don't think I am. Grab that revive. Maybe? Yeah, I gotta revive. Hell yeah. There we go. Platform looks like it's made out of denim. There we go. Ooh. Oh wow, I got here quick. Denim platform. The gelatform. Okay. One of these works on this guy. I forget which one it is, and I'm going to scream at this boss. Well, this part. How we're gonna, the only way we're gonna get through this is just blindly firing into the abyss there. Come on, come on, let's make it. Come on, yeah, there we go. Imagine being stationed in that tunnel. Just like, yeah, your goal here is to just kind of chill. To guard this specific portion of the tunnel. Oh. Did. guys come from? Yeah, you gotta get through those doors before they close. Which is always, like, the scariest part for me. So then otherwise you gotta open them up. Go back through. It's not even that scary, it's just... Man, I don't want to go back and do that again. But Kyle Katarn, certified badass, can do it. So I have to get back up here. Hey, they restocked this place with storms. Did that guy just, like, teleport? Or did my eyes deceive me? Take me off the red wasteland so my eyes can not burn. Yeah.
This contemptible excuse for an officer will no longer divulge any more information to that rebel, Kyle Katarn.
Katarn will not be as easy to deal with. He is very resourceful. More resourceful, it seems, than even your dark troopers.
I understand the threat, Lord Vader. Katarn was once an impressive Imperial officer, but he was weak and gave up on the struggle for our new order. I wouldn't put much faith in his abilities. Katarn will never come near this ship. My new hire will see to that.
Boba Fett. I don't think the Boba Fett looks as good. Granted, they're going for the more kind of cartoonish style, which is fine. That's cool. But in the original Dark Forces, they used, like, movie footage. And they used it pretty well. It was pretty well spliced in there. But to just suddenly have it be this, like, cartoonish style was, like, that's a little jarring. Anyways, we gotta rescue Crix Maydeen now. Dude got his ass caught. Whoa!
Surrender him!
And apparently this is a level that I had always just kind of janked. Or not janked, cheesed, that's the word. Apparently I always cheesed this level and got past a lot of the, like, random, or not random, but, like, I got past a lot of the rigmarole of this level the way I did it. Come here, pizza slice. Oop. So maybe I'll play nice this time. Ah! Yeah, they definitely added more enemies on easy mode here. Yeah. Come on. Hit it. Hit it. Hit it. There we go. What is your purpose here? We're gonna seal you in this room. Don't ask us why, we're just gonna do it. Whoops. There he is. I always cheese it that way. Yeah, one mine. The most useless weapon in the game. I don't think I ever once have used the mine. Oh my god. I don't think I've ever once used the mines in this game, but the enemy sure does, and they are certainly useful. Useful to them, rather. Come on, let me get up there. Never actually been up there before. In all my years of playing this game, I never even noticed that. Oh boy, this is gonna kill me now. Once I'm done streaming, I'm just gonna have to spend all my time going through. See, there's the mine. That's what I'm talking about. Oh, Jesus, what the... Wow, okay. Thank you for the shield replacements. That's very much needed. A bit crowded in there. Yeah, absolutely. Destroy a mouse droid. Oh, rodent exterminator. Oh, you fuck. You absolute... Oh, you bitch. No! Oh! Who makes a room like that? Yeah, that one doesn't open. No, it does open. This guy. Going through some of this level, like I knew what I did, but going through some of this level is like, I haven't been through this level through like, without cheesing it, I haven't been through this level in a long time. That's the security. Ah! Fuck. That's the security there. There we go. Sometimes it's... Forgot, this is one where sometimes it's on and sometimes it isn't. Again, I have not legitimately done this level in a while. Another one, okay. Oh, me and my, okay. Where do I get the red key? I'm trying to time it, but I'm trying to time how long the quick flashes go. But my brain is also trying to count how many flashes are happening, which does not work. I am gonna need some med kits. Ah. Okay, well, I feel like there should be an elevator. Oops. Wonder if this is... Probably not. I don't think I have this key card. I could try it. Did anything? Nope, did not. Kind of what I figured. Key card is not orange.
Stop where you are.
These guys will have it though. There you go. Hey. Jesus, they put a landmine in here with the prisoners. That's horrible. And what was the other one? Cruelty, absolutely. Oh, there we go. Yes, give me the shields. I don't know why my headlamp just came on. Oh, there's just stuff down there. Oh, there's a shit pile of landmines. One door to the right that I have not gone. Let's see if I can do this real quick. Oh, fuck, I gotta get in. Oh! I was hoping I could just quickly get in there. I can't. Okay, so. I went through the torture chamber there. Oh, hey. Taking that. This is where I started, right? Yep, it sure is. So, let's see. I don't know what to do with this guy. I know where those two go, I believe. But... oh, fucking blue door. I'm an idiot. It's right here. Ooh, we got the mortar launcher. Kind of a not a great level to get it, but you know. Anything I missed in these levels that? Oh wait. That was just that. Okay. That was that. There's nothing back here, right? Okay. These little sections of doorway that just get, like, passed up. Or these little doorways that get passed up. It's down there, what am I missing? Obviously this place is a nightmare and I probably don't want to go down here. But now you probably see why I always cheese the level. I feel like I'm missing something. I'm gonna have to like watch someone actually play this level, because again, it's been a long time since I've actually legitimately beaten this. Oh, there's something up there. A little thing up there, a little pathway up there. Interesting to turn on the map sometimes. Can we get here, right? And then we're kind of locked off here. But we have our two key codes. Can't really, like, there's nothing we can do in this room. This is where I remember getting stuck as a kid, and then eventually I just figured out how to cheese it. Which I think I'm just gonna do. Because I don't want to waste any more time here. This is how I've done it every single time, is just doing this without going through any of the other floors or anything, just straight to this. Oh wait, no, I think you do need, I think you need to go through that to actually get the key code to Crix Maydeen's cell. If I, like, open this door, hey, look where I came out. Oh no, I mean, I could have just done the whole thing and like I always do. Right? Nope, I got an interrogation. Ramsey's head. Alright. Leader of the Dark Trooper Project is a general named Rom Mach. That dude. Anyways, I'm sure there's a lot of great backstory there, but right now we're just showing off this fancy schmancy thing. Place the tracking device in the rear of the smuggler ship. Alright. Blast through these guys. Let's go the other way real quick, just to see if there's any more stuff I can stock on. Or you can even, he killed himself, that's fine. I ran into it, that's smart of me. Test. That's interesting. God damn it. Shields. Oh. Little hidey hole. Okay. Right in the face. Whoa! Very cool. Thank you. That's the cargo area room. Let's explore a little bit. Get some goodies. Plus, I don't think we can just go straight into the cargo area. I think we actually have to do something. Dudes just like randomly show up. Yeah, I need red keys and such. There we go. Well, shit. I thought that was it. Space urinal. Space urinal, aka the piss wall, exactly. Notice that when you get hit, the screen will flash green and then red, which is very confusing to me, because in the original, it will flash... Who's shooting at me? Are you down here? Because in the original, it just flashes green when just your shield is hit, and it only flashes red when your health is hit. For me, it's a little confusing. Because then I'm like, oh, did I suddenly take a hit to my health? Nope, no I did not. Nope, go back down, thank you. This was unnecessary. Bloop. Ah! fucking knew that was gonna happen at some point. Where the... There they are. Bloop. I killed two mouse droids, but did not fucking deactivate the mine. Or rather, activate the mine. Fine.
Tracking device is secured.
Picking up the signal. Looks like we're done here.
Alright, let's bounce, dog. Okay. Here's what I'm gonna do. We have to go back here. We have the vault here, right? Which is really cool. We have all these pre-rendered images that we can check out, which I think this is really cool that they did this. Alternative perspective of the briefing room where Kyle Katarn is briefed by Mon Mothma prior to his mission on Talay, ultimately discarded. Renders of the Executor's Bridge where General Mock converses with Darth Vader during a cutscene from previous angles, or from various angles. Oh. Okay. Oh, I see. Oh, that's cool. Java's ship exterior. That's cool. Weapons. What we got here? There's our Imperial repeater. Oh, there's the Dark Trooper weapon. One that I still don't entirely know how it works, but I guess there we see the handle on the side there. There's the mortar launcher, which I don't know how you hold that exactly. Phase 2 Dark Trooper, let's see what we got here. Oh, there he is, he chunky boy. We like him. Oh, there we go, got a nice action shot, that's cool. Nice lighting there. With a solar flare, too. Lens flare. Phase 3, here's the big baddie. Now, if you get a Dark Trooper action figure, this is the one you get. You get the Phase 3. It's really cool. I had one of those when I was a kid. I do not have it anymore. Part of my soul is missing that. Firing Stormtrooper. Concept art. Kyle Katarn rough draft. early design sketch for Kyle Katarn that shares many similarities with Final Version. Okay. Oh wait, does he have like a hood? Oh, I guess his jacket has a hood on it. I didn't even realize that. Jan. Hell yeah. Jan's awesome. General Mock, what do we have here? Okay. Dark Troopers, okay. Oh dang, they were like big mech suit boys initially. Big stompy boys. Oh, there's their height. Okay. There's the phase one, who we fought in the red planet. And you can get an action figure of these guys too. The Kel Dragon. Yeah, he big bad boy. Briar Blaster. That's very cool. Cutscene development. Rotoscoping Kyle and Jabba. Oh, that's wild. That's wild. Okay. So it's one of the devs doing that. That's pretty wild. I was going to say, it looks like Justin Chin. Rotoscoping is a process by which an animator can trace over video. This technique is used in the scene where Kyle confronts the hologram on Jabba the Hutt's ship. Displayed here is Justin Chin, the artist and story lead for Dark Forces, performing the required motions in the cutscene. I just want to blow this up again. That's just so cool. Also, guess what? I'm going to buy Baldur's Gate. Oh, that's awesome. That's awesome. I wish I could get into that. When I watched Danger stream it a couple times, I was like, I just want to play D&D now. But now that I play D&D, maybe I'll get into it more. Maybe. We'll see. Kyle's Award. Oh, okay. That's at the very end. Video shows Justin Chin, the lead designer of Dark Forces, performing the scene where Mon Mothma presents a medal to Kyle Katarn at the award ceremony. Final version, Kyle is not seen physically taking the case, meaning the video is not used as reference. Okay. Kyle's defeat, down and out. Weapon gripped. Taking aim. Firing. Ah, okay, so this is supposed to be like a game over screen, or a lose screen, or cinematic rather, if you lost the final battle. Okay, that's pretty dope, actually. Nice. Okay, so we went through all of those, so time to play The Avenger! Because this is where I'm going to end stream. I'm going to end stream after I play The Avenger. So The Avenger was a playable prototype for the first stage in Dark Forces, taking place on board a Star Destroyer. This level was included in the CES, Consumer Electronics Show, demo, and some images from it ended up in promotional materials. While aspects were recycled into other parts of the game, the Avenger itself was ultimately cut due to concerns for being too difficult for new players. And, yes it is, let me tell you. Alright, here we go. Oh yeah, they didn't really re-render this. You can see it's still chunky graphics, like I'm checking my corners. It's a modern FPS. Oh, fuck me. I forgot, this level does have a lot of turrets in it. Oh yeah, see, I'm taking heavy damage. Because there's no easy way to take care of those turrets. Unless there is, and I'm just an idiot, which is perfectly plausible. those guys, and take care of those guys. Damn. Just take all of my health, why don't you? It's interesting how, in this version, the officers drop the blaster rifle, whereas in the final game, they do not have that. Magnetic ceiling where all the blaster shots ricochet off. Like how the tabletop here is just a skybox. Not necessarily a skybox, but a, you know, sky texture. Only way I can think to do it. I turned my headlight on. I'm so used to reloading. So used to reloading that I compulsively press R. This is definitely from the executor level, but I did miss something. I absolutely did miss something. Because that's actually getting towards the end of the map. I do think I actually have to go this way. In this death trap room here. That whole room is just a nightmare and a half. Oh, jeez. Love to throw you into a crowded room. Ah, so see, look familiar. Look familiar, yes. Mm-hmm. Familiar, yes. Mm-hmm. Whoa! Right onto the bridge of the Star Destroyer. Which, as you can see, hey, there it is. Into all the little ventilation ducts. There's the plans, but just kind of keep moseying around here. Death Star planes. Whoop. Whoop. There we go. And then we can just choose, hey, where do we want to end up? How about right there? Boom. All right. Once again, it's behind me. This is a part that, when I first played this level, really irritated me. This platforming is not fun. You bitch. Alright. Of course, that's where I miss it. I will be doing this a lot. Or maybe not. This is when having a thermal detonator would be very much in handy. And these sections are taken from the executor level as well. I wonder wonder if I could actually fall into space. I don't want to test it, but... Anywho. But there we go. Mission objectives complete. Ideally, we'd be escaping in a TIE fighter. And there you have it. Yep, that was the Avenger level. That was the prototype.